It's Jay Triano on the Folsom Lake Honda Hotline. Folsom Lake Honda, your one-stop Honda shop. Coach, let me ask you first before we get into the game stuff. Does the staff and players tangibly feel the building of excitement over this team from the fan base? Do you guys, is it palpable to you?
Oh, for sure. It's unbelievable. It's a great experience. You know, I've been with a couple of organizations prior to coming here, and just the home crowd, you feel it here. You feel the energy. I talked to Doug Christie quite a bit. He keeps telling me, he goes, it gets crazy here. It gets crazy. And he said, this is similar to when he played. And you certainly feel it. It is like a playoff atmosphere for us, and it's a huge advantage for us. So let's keep it going.
I think even the most optimistic Kings fan and talking heads who do things like what me and Nick do for a living have been surprised and pleasantly so by what the Kings have done this year and exceeded our expectations. Is there any feeling of that in the building, or is there no ceiling on what you guys think you can do or expectations?
You know, it's interesting. We've kind of blocked everything out. You know, we don't really have limitations or restrictions for what we're trying to do. I think Mike, Coach Brown, has made it real evident from the very beginning that we're not going to be happy with wins. We're not going to be happy with losses. We're going to go to work every day, and we're just going to keep plugging away. And I think that's our focus on the process over the outcomes has really kept us in a straight line, driving towards the right direction. And you know, if we have a couple of games where we're not so good, we're going to address it. We're going to figure out why. We're not afraid to call guys out. Guys aren't afraid to call each other out. And I think that's one of the reasons we've been able to just stay kind of locked in right now. We don't want to hear the noise. We don't want to hear about how good we're doing. We just want to stay, you know, present and locked in on every single game, really.
Coach Jay Triano with us. Coach, winning without Domas on the road last night. What's that say about this team?
Well, I think it says a lot. I think, you know, our attention to the scouting reports, our attention to detail, guys who have not been playing, staying ready, the development of our players. I think that there's a lot of things that can be said. But I think having an offensive and a defensive system in place certainly helps. Having guys that, you know, we make sure that even if they're not in rotation, they stay in shape. You know, Rashard Holmes coming in last night and doing what he did was just phenomenal. And he was fired up to be able to do it because he's been itching at a chance to play. So you really feel good for the team, but you also feel good for some individuals who get a more of a chance when somebody steps up. And I think that, you know, we've talked all along about the depth of our team. You know, we've got very good players that maybe aren't even in rotation right now or that want to be playing more minutes. But I think that's the depth of our team. We're going to ride with whoever's going to help us win. If somebody goes down, we're going to have a guy step in. And last night was a perfect example.
You know, we've heard stay ready a lot since Rashawn Holmes' game last night. And he's not the first one who is sort of called into action by an injury or a sickness. I remember a Terrence Davis game in Toronto earlier this year where he did something similar. What do you guys mean when you say stay ready? Can you give us a peek behind the scenes and what these guys who maybe aren't regular parts of the rotation, but still come up big when needed, what do they do to quote unquote stay ready, Coach?
Well, today's a good example. I mean, we got home last night. I think by the time everybody was home, it was 2 a.m. The young guys who did not get enough minutes or who did not play the required number of minutes were in and playing live today at 11 o'clock. The vet players that played a certain number of minutes, those guys came in at noon. And so we all kind of met at noon. But when we meet at noon, there's guys that have been going 100% full scrimmage or skills and drills for at least an hour. So, you know, that extra hour is kind of helped them, you know, for their aerobic standpoint and for their physical standpoint so that they can stay basketball skill ready. And, you know, it's just getting them here early. I mean, I'm sure they all got home at the same time, but they don't want to go in that extra hour early, but they do. They go in, they're professional, they get their work done. And I think times like that help these guys stay, you know, on the same page as everybody else because, you know, maybe they didn't play last night, but they got it in today. They'll still be ready to play in a game tomorrow.
Coach Jay Triano is with us. He's on the Folsom Lake Honda Hotline. Folsom Lake Honda, one-stop Honda shop, Cattles Rami, Sacktown Sports. Coach, I want to go back to Rashawn Holmes specifically. I don't want to try to psychoanalyze anybody, try to jump into their head, but you know, when you watch Rashawn this year, is there a chance that he's been pressing a little bit? And last night there was no Domas, so he was a little bit more confident that he could just kind of get some minutes, and he was just going out there and playing instead of trying to not make mistakes?
I think that plays a factor for in everybody's role. You know, we've had other games where, you know, you play against teams or even your team is down a couple of players. The guy going in knows he's going to play. He knows that he can't be pulled if he makes a mistake or two, because we just don't have the depth that night. Last night, Rich probably felt the same way. Like, I'm going to play. I don't have to do anything in my first 2 minutes to warrant me staying on the floor. I'm going to have to play half a game at some point. Mezzi will come in for me, but I don't have the pressure of that. So I think psychologically there is that, where, you know, guys get a chance to play. But at the same time, I think also our style of play last night was a little bit different. You know, we were much more pick and roll dominant last night than we normally are. We're one of the lowest pick and roll teams in the NBA. But with Rich, that's his strength, and we had to play to his strength. Domas' strength is playing off the dribble handoff and having him be a little bit more of a playmaker. So our style strategically at the offensive end last night was a little bit different. And I just thought overall defensively, we were as I don't want to say shrunk into the lane and protecting the paint better than we have been in the past little bit. And I think Rich plays a big part of that, because he's a big body and he's not afraid to be physical when players get in there.
Yeah, and Coach Brown, before the Lakers game, almost challenged his guys to do a better job of protecting the paint after 70-plus points put up by the Lakers last time these two teams met. Is that was that the main difference, as you put it, shrinking into the lane and putting a little bit more, just a little bit more manpower and big bodies down there to clog things up?
Yeah, for sure. You know, I mean, it's no secret the Lakers right this year, they're struggling with the 3-point shot. And when we played them last time, we just, you know, there were too many holes, and, you know, their whole strategy is try to get to the rim, find a gap, get into the lane, see if they can get to the rim. And they were able to do that. And LeBron is so big and strong. He can go past guys. He can absorb contact and still get past you. Last night we were bound and determined to show him more bodies than we did the previous time that we played them. Make sure that he saw one or two guys, make them throw that pass. We knew that Christie might hit a shot or two, or you know, Brown Jr. might hit a shot or two. Nunn hit a couple of shots, but we weren't going to overreact to those guys shooting when we knew LeBron was passing, and we want that, because we don't want him putting it on the floor and getting inside where he can do damage.
Coach Jay Triano with us. Coach, just a few more for you, and again, thanks for your time. We've seen this happen several times this year. We're last night talking about points in the paint. 24 points in the paint in the first quarter for the Lakers, 26 points in the paint the rest of the game. Why have there been so many stretches here where it seems like you guys kind of lose that, you know, ability to defend the paint and protect the paint, and then other stretches you do a good job of it? What are you lacking consistently to get that done?
I think the game starts, and I think everybody's in a little bit of a feeling out process. Like, for me offensively, I think we take too many middies early in the game, but, you know, guys are just starting to get into their groove. I'd like to see us drive and kick and shoot more threes early. At the defensive end, I think we were like, okay, well, we're doing a good job. And then all of a sudden it's a slap in the face. No, we're not doing a good enough job. You know, we have to be shrunk more. Sometimes it takes a timeout. Sometimes it takes the halftime. But coaches on these guys, Jordy's on these guys. We got to, you know, we have to be more shrunk to score more bodies. And I honestly think a lot of it had to do with the fact of who we were playing. You know, you're playing against LeBron James. If you're not going to be in there, he's going to embarrass you. And I think it finally, you know, got through to us after that first quarter. We better be inside in the lane, force them to take tough shots. They made a couple early in the game, too, especially LeBron. LeBron, I think he made 2 threes in the first quarter.
Yep.
And it was like, holy smokes, is this going to happen? And then I think you start doubting yourself, whether are we protecting the lane too much and we're giving him these outside shots. But I think you have to play the odds in that situation. And, you know, we were better at protecting the lane, and of course they cooled off and didn't make shots at the rate that they did in the first quarter.
You know, we're talking about adjustments that your team has made defensively. I think it was the last time we talked to you that you said you got your goal is to get up 43 pointers a game. And this sport, all sports, are about adjustments and adjustments to adjustments. Have you seen, are we at the point in the season yet where other teams have caught on to your goal to get up those 43 point shots? and are defending you guys differently?
Yeah, and I don't know if it's so much teams defending us strategically every game, because, you know, teams have their defensive system, and, you know, some teams will push out. I don't think there's too many games and too few practices where you can change your philosophy defensively. You know, Lakers, the first part of the year, I think they made an adjustment halfway through the year to their whole, not just us, but to how they were going to defend. They were like number one at defending the rim and giving up a lot of threes. We had, you know, spray attempts or where we get in the lane and kick out. We had over 20 and 25 the first two times we played them. We haven't been able to get up 33 since, but they're not as good at the rim as they were earlier in the year. So I think, you know, teams try to figure out, well, are we going to take away the rim? Or are we going to take away the three? And, you know, I think we struggle really when teams, you know, try to take away the three. We don't get that 40 up. At the same time, we've got two great interior players. You know, when Domas is healthy, he's rolling, and Foxy can get to wherever he wants on the court. So, you know, last night was a good example. We only got up 30 threes last night, which is below par for us. But at the same time, when you look at the lineup that we had and the way that we had to play last night, it was probably a fairly fair number.
Really quick one for you, Coach. One last question for you. You guys have not won when I walk into the building, when I'm at Golden One. Tomorrow night, I plan on being at the game, and we're trying to break my curse. We're calling it the Cattle's Curse. Do you have any advice on how I could break this curse tomorrow night?
Yeah, I've got two tickets to the theater tomorrow night. If you can go see this show, and then we'll let you know how the game went after that.
Coach, thanks. It's always great to catch up with you. We'll do this again soon. I appreciate you.
Sounds good. Thank you, guys.
All right, there goes Coach Jay Triano, Folsom Lake Honda Hotline.
Stay away.
Folsom Lake Honda, your one-stop Honda shop. Get out! We don't want you here. Oh, my goodness. That was fantastic. I was thinking he'd say something good. He's got a really good person. He's really funny. I figured he'd be quick-witted enough. Sometimes you catch coaches off, you know, off guard. They're like, wait a minute, what, huh?
I don't like telling coaches or players about things like that. You know what I mean? Because it doesn't impact, I don't think it impacts the play or their performance until they know about it. When you talk about curses and things like that, you know what I mean?
So you think Triano's going to be thinking about me tomorrow night?
I just hope, maybe. He's like, where's this Cattle's guy?
I don't think he'll
At one point, you're going to look down and he's going to be staring right back at you.
Doing the fingers to the eyes.
Yeah, I see you.
I see you, Cattle. I told you to go to the theater.
This is your fault.
His other hand, he's got the two tickets to the theater. I told you, man. I told you. Oh, my God. Time to check out Coastside Medical Clinic.